بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Tonight we'll talk about common mistake of Adam. Allah عز وجل gave big reward for Adam, the one who performed Adam. حديث صحيح البخاري، النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said لو يعلم الناس ما في الأذان والصف الأول ثم لم يجدوا إلا أن يستهموا عليه لاستهم. If you know the big reward الله عز وجل give to those who perform Adhan and could not do it unless with looting or drafting with others, making Qura, do it. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has five people who performed Adhan in his time. Bilal ibn Abi Rabah, Abdullah ibn Maktoum, those in Medina. أبو محذورة، أبو محذورة في مكة. There are two others when he's traveling. One is زياد السدائي. The other is called سعد القرظي. Adhan before time is haram. If it was intention, if you do Adhan intentionally before its right time, that's haram. And you have to repeat it. إيقاع الأذان قبل وقته إذا كان سن متعمد حرام، لا يجوز ويجب أن يعيده ولا تتأتى به السنة. There are many mistakes, common mistakes in Adhan. People should care about it because this big reward, هذا الأجر العظيم, only for those who performed Adhan perfectly. But if you do it improper, will not get, as we said last time, will not get Adhan, but will get punishment. One of the mistake which is common was called in Arabic التطريب, singing. Singing of Adhan, if it is mild, that's makruh, only makruh. If it is too much, that's kabir. في the singing is too much, that's haram. What mean singing or تطريب? تطريب means to cut the voice and make voice not smooth, like to say أشهد أن that's singing forbidden. It's not good to do like that. If this singing is too much and horrible, that's haram, and Adhan should be repeated. Famous alim in 10th century called Mullah Ali al-Qari, that's famous in قراءات. He give what you can call it too much singing, which is forbidden, what is not forbidden. For example, he said, if you said to make voice longer than it is according to the قواعد rules of قراءات of reciting. If you exceed these rules, like to say, when you say Allahu Akbar, he said Allahu Akbar, you should not exceed two finger movement. Well, you should not make voice longer than that. You can't say Allahu Akbar. If you say that, you mean to make voice too long, which is equal to four movement of your fingers. Allahu, that's forbidden. That's not good. He said, lot of people over the world of make mistake in this special takbir. Very little people who can put it right. The right takbir is to make voice equal to two movement of your finger. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. That's in Adhan, that's in Takbir, because that's what's called Al-Madd Al-Asli. Al-Madd Al-Asli in Quran, this, the stress for this voice should not exceed two movements of your fingers in Adhan or in Salah or in reciting Quran, all the same. If you see, if you reach four movement, that's forbidden. You can't say Allahu Akbar. People think that's better. Well, you notice those who performing adhan over the world, even in Haram, Mecca or Medina, very little people who can do it right. You notice all a lot of people, 90% of people who perform adhan can't say Allahu Akbar. No, they say Allahu Akbar. That's not good. That's forbidden. That's not the opinion of the Sheikh. All ulama agreed on this rule. None of them you say, if you can say Allahu Akbar, it is right. No one of them. Open the world. All ulama. So this mistake, we have to make attention about it. That's one mistake of adhan. Other common mistake, to give voice when start lafz al-jalala, Allahu Akbar. Don't say Allahu Akbar. Don't say that, because that change the statement from positive statement to testify that Allahu Akbar, change it to a question mark, asking whether Allahu Akbar or not. Different meaning. So if you say Allahu Akbar, that's very wrong. Other common mistake, to say Allahu Akbar, change Akbar to Wa. Don't say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Other mistake, to say Allahu Akbar, to give long voice for Ba, Ba. Akbar. This is wrong to say that. The right to say Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Some people say Ashhadu anna la ilaha illallah, which is not right. Not to say Ashhadu anna la ilaha illallah. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. Don't say أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. If you put stress on Anna, thus will give very wrong meaning. Thus mean, if you say أشهد أن محمد رسول الله means you testify that Muhammad رسول الله. But if you say أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, that's different meaning. That means to testify that yourself محمد رسول الله. Was very wrong. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله, عندما تقول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله كأنك تقول أشهد أنني أنا محمد رسول الله. Well, to say that it is very wrong, you see. The other thing is حي على الصلاة, not to say حي على الصلاة, حي على الصلاة. The right one to say حي 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 على الصلاة, not حي على الصلاة. Other thing, حي على الصلاة, not حي على الصلاة. Some people say حي على الصلاة. No. حي على الصلاة. Again, حي على الفلاح. You say حي على الفلاح. Not حي على الفلاح. Some people say حي على الفلاح. حي. You should pronounce الحاء, the last letter in the word حي على الفلاح. This mistakes are common. We have to pay attention to it. Especially Allahu Akbar. Lot of people don't know about that. They think if you say Allahu Akbar, that's right. Unfortunately, all ulama of the world say it is wrong, haram in adhan, haram. Sheikh Ali al-Qari, which is very famous قاري مشهور من علماء القراءات من علماء الحنفية, رجل عالم ومحدث ينقل الإجماع. All علماء say if you give this voice more than three movements, if you reach four movement fingers to say الله, if you reach that, هو ينقل الإجماع. All علماء العالم الإسلامي from رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم up to his time, all these علماء اتفقوا gathering that this adhan is قبيح, حرام, is not right, مخالف لما كان عليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأصحابه في الأدب. صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.